Unacademy is providing daily T20 free practice tests for both the TS and AP MCET. It has started on November 2nd. Week 1 contains biology, zoology, physics, chemistry, mathematics. In week 1, there will be 5 quizzes. In week 2, there will be 5 quizzes. And in week 2, quiz will be on botany, zoology, physics, chemistry and mathematics. And week 4 quiz will be 4 quizzes. So the quiz will be on botany, zoology, physics and chemistry. Don't forget to enroll for Unacademy and make sure you give this free practice test so that you can analyze your performance and work on its improvement. Hi friends, welcome back to Best Way to Study. In this video, we are going to see the complete tutorial of UML. Okay, so UML, what are the uses of UML and what are the types of UML? All these things we are going to see in this particular tutorial. So make sure you watch this video till the end and also don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon so that you'll never miss a video from Best Way to Study. Okay, so now let's begin this video without any delay. First of all, let's see what is the full form of UML. UML stands for Unified Modeling Language. Okay, so name itself saying that it is a modeling language. That is, we use the pictographical representation. We use diagrams and pictures in order to represent the language. Okay, because instead of text, if the text is converted into diagrams, we can understand the context of the text very easily. Okay, so now let's see. And UML language, like Unified Modeling Language, is the language which is very standard and used by all the companies, okay, all the organizations. Let's see what are the different types of diagrams in UML. Okay, so first most important diagram is use case. Okay, so what is use case? For example, let's think client came to organization, asked the organization in order to develop a website, okay, user friendly website. What is the next step? Organization will ask the client what is the requirement, like what are the different kinds of requirements, and the client will explain. For example, let's think there is a online ticket booking website. Like for example, let's think client wants the organization to develop a online ticket booking website. Okay, so now organization people need to ask client in detail what all are the requirements. Then client will be telling all the requirements. Okay, so first step of the organization is they need to gather all the requirements. Okay, client will be explaining one by one. Okay, so first of all, once the user enters the main page, home page of the website, they need to sign up, and then after signing up, they need to book the ticket. They should be able to see what all are the ticket prices available and for what, which all places the transport is available. All this kind of stuff they need to see. The user should be able to choose a ticket and book the ticket. After booking the ticket, he need to make the online payment. After online payment, the status needs to be seen, like a status of the online payment needs to be pop up, like transaction successful or payment successful, or if the payment is not successful, then it should be like payment unsuccessful. All this kind of things it need to become. The e-copy of the ticket needs to be sent to the user's email. So all these requirements, client will explain to the organization. Okay, people who are working in organizations will have knowledge on technical terms, technical language and all, but coming to the client, he's a normal person, he can't understand all the technical terms. So it will be better if we use a pictographical format and explain the client what all they understood, what all the people of the organization understood from client's explanation. Okay, for that reason we mainly use use cases. Okay, use cases are nothing but it is a pictographical format, it is a diagram which uses text as well as diagrams. Okay, why we use case is an effective technique. Like using diagram or use case, we can easily understand what all are the requirements of the website or what are the requirements of the system, and also we can easily explain the same to the client or the project. Okay, so now let's see why we use case and what are the advantages of use case. Okay, so first important advantage, as I already told, it is used to gather the requirements of a system. In order to draw a use case, in order to make a use case, first of all we need to gather all the requirements of the system. Okay, so next is outside view of the system. For example, use case is used to get the outside view of the system. What does this mean? See, using the use case, the user can clearly understand how can he sign up, how can he log in, how can he book the ticket, how can he use the website, all these steps. Okay, it will be very helpful in order to understand in a better way for the end user. Okay, there will be a good outside view of a system. Okay, so next is can also understand what are the internal and external features. Okay, so once we understand the requirements thoroughly, only we will be able to use the use case, we will be able to draw the use case. If we are stuck in between and if we are unable to draw the use case, it means that we didn't understand the requirements thoroughly, so that we can happily go back to the client and ask him to give more requirements. Okay, and next is there will be interaction. Okay, using use case we can understand who all will have interaction. For example, user will be having interaction with website, admin will have interaction with the website. So like this we can understand who all will have interaction with the website. Okay, so this is an example of use case. Okay, now let's see what is this example. Okay, once we develop the website, it's not end. Okay, we need to keep on updating the website very frequently, very often. Okay, for maintaining the website up to date, we need a person called admin. Okay, admin is a human being, that's why we are using human being diagram. Okay, so there will be only one admin, that's why we are using one. Okay, so and what will admin do? He will update the website. Okay, that's why I have drawn a vowel shape, circular vowel shape, and I have represented his online update. Okay, admin will be updating the website online, that's why here I have written as admin update. Okay, so there is a relationship, direct relationship between website and admin, that's why I have drew a line, direct line. Okay, so and in order to understand better, I have written here admin update. There will be one admin who will directly update the website, who will make direct online updates to the websites. Okay, so why I have written n means number of, there will be n number of, we'll say, right? So coming to updates, there will not be a single update, right? There will be multiple number of updates, that's why here I have written n. Okay, admin will be making n number of updates in the official website. Okay, so the next is, what is the other thing which admins do? Admins will also be able to see the Score. Let's think. This is the website of a which will show the online cricket scores updates. Okay, so admin will also be able to view the scores. Okay, admin can also access and view the scores, what all updates he made. Okay, he can n number of scores, like scores will be changing every now and then, right? That's why I have mentioned it as n. Okay, so this is one, and here again we have connected with a line because there is a direct relationship between admin and viewing scores. Admin can directly view the scores and there will be n number of scores, like so. This is the relationship of admin with the website and admin with the view scores. Now let's see, apart from the admin, who all can use the website? Obviously users. Okay, any website will be made only for users, right? So there will be n number of users. Okay, there will be multiple number of users coming to this particular site. Users can also update the scores. Okay, not only admin, users also will have a limited access in order to update the scores. Okay, this users update the scores again, admin will recheck it, reconfirm it whether they are correct or not. So there will be n number of users and there will be n number of updates. That's why there's a direct line, because there's a direct correlation between users and updates. Okay, so next is, there will be n number of users who can view n number of scores. That's why n again on this line I have written users viewing scores. Okay, so this is all about use case diagram. Now let's see what are the other things about the use case. Okay, so why do we use cases? In order to maintain some diagram in a organized manner. Okay, and actors, as I already told, actors are the human beings who will directly interact with the system. Okay, use case, there will be three different types of things which can be used. There will be three different items. One is functionalities, actors, relationships. Functionalities, actors, relationships. As I have already told you, this is functionality, these are actors, and this is relationship. Only by using these three, we have completed our use case diagram. Okay, so yeah, that's it for today. Hope you found this video useful. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon so that you'll never miss a video from Best Way to Study. And also don't forget to like and share this video with all your friends. Thanks for watching.